Good morning to all. Today we are going to learn the canons of classification. Are you ready, students? So let's learn canons of library classification. Welcome to this class, all dear students. Today we are going to learn the canons of library classification. After attending this lecture, we'll be able to know what is meant by canons, what are the canon of idea plane, verbal plane and notational plane. We have to learn in total 43 canons of library classification. So let's learn one by one. Madam, can you make us understand what is meant by canon? Yes, let's understand what is canon. Canons means a rule, regulation or law. It can also be defined as a principle, model, standard or criterion, hence various models, principles, test used for the working and efficiency of different schemes of classification are called canons of classification. Canons means a rule, regulation or law. It can also be defined as a principle, model, standard or criterion, hence various models, principles, test used for the working and efficiency of different schemes of classification are called canons of classification. Dr. Ranganathan recognized three plane of work to explain the design and application of work. He provided a specific norms for designing a scheme of classification and classify the documents according to it. In designing a scheme for classification, it is to deal with dynamics, infinite and multidimensional universe knowledge which need to be clearly and thoroughly analyzed. Thereafter, it is required to be transformed into an artificial language for smooth and convenient use of the scheme, as well as systematic and helpful arrangement of documents. To make this complicated system smooth, Ranganathan has formulated a separate set of canons for work into three plane. They are 1. Idea plane, 2. Verbal plane, and 3. Notational plane. Okay, madam. Now we could understand the meaning of canon. Thank you, madam. Let's go ahead, dear students. The first used of canons of library classification by W.C. B. Sayers. Then many library science professionals tried to development of canons of library classification, such as E.C. Richardson, H.E. Bliss, etc. In the 1937 criticized the canons of library classification by Dr. Ranganathan in his book Prolegomena to Library Classification. Let's see the canons for the idea plane. In idea plane, all aspects of the universe of knowledge are analyzed by its structure, dimensions, qualities, characteristics, kind of relationship and bond of strength among each item of knowledge. A scheme for classification assumes the prior concept of a scheme of classes. A scheme of classification involves 5 inherent concepts. They are: A. Canons for characteristics. B. Canons for succession of characteristics. C. Canons for array. D. Canons for chain. And canons for filiatory sequence. Then let's see the canons for the verbal plane. Verbal plane helps to decide the type of terminology to be used in the scheme of classification. Natural language is imperfect. There is a vagueness in the meaning of ordinary words used in everyday conversation. There are also the incidence of homonyms and synonyms. New terms appear from time to time, and these may be used to express new ideas. The meaning of a new term often keeps changing from time to time, unless it is accepted in the concerned subject. Classifiers are concerned with the application of schemes. They may find this useful in interpreting the terms in the schedule at the time of classifying documents. These canons must be followed by those engaged in the designing and construction of the schedules of a scheme. Ranganathan has formulated the following canons of work at the verbal plane. They are: A. Canons of context. B. Canons of enumeration. C. Canons of currency. And canons of reticence. Are you getting my points, dear students, so that we can go ahead? Yes, madam. Please go ahead. Okay, we will see next plane. IE canons for notational plane. It is the responsibility of implementing the findings of the idea plane. While designing the scheme of classification, the idea plane decides the necessary characteristics to be used for the arrangement of the universe of subjects in the filiatory sequence. The notational plane therefore has to provide the mechanism in the form of the notational system for the helpful and systematic arrangement for the existing as well as for future unknown subjects and a scheme for classification. The canons for notational plane are: canon of synonym, canon of homonym, canon of relativity and canon of uniformity. canon of hierarchy and canon of non-hierarchy, canon of mixed notation and canon of pure notation, canon of faceted notatio and canon of non-faceted notation, and canon of coextensiveness and canon of underextensiveness. So these are all canons of three-plane students. Today we are ending our class here. Tomorrow we will go into the depth meaning of each canons. Till then, keep learning and bye-bye, we will meet tomorrow. Thank you all students. Keep the questions ready for tomorrow's class. Thank you. Bye.